Let's begin with phylum Hemichordata. Earlier, this phylum was considered a subphylum under chordates. However, due to certain features, taxonomists have classified this phylum as non-chordates. Let's take a look at the characteristic features of this phylum. Hemichordates are small, worm-like marine animals. They are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, coelomate animals with an organ system level of organization. Their cylindrical body is divided into proboscis, collar, and trunk. Hemichordates respire through gills and have an open circulatory system. The proboscis gland functions as an excretory organ. Hemichordates are dioecious and fertilization is external with indirect development. Balanoglossus and Sacoglossus are examples of this phylum. Now, let's take a look at the characteristic features of phylum Chordata. Chordates are animals with a notochord, a dorsal, hollow nerve cord, paired pharyngeal gill slits, and a postanal tail. They are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, coelomate animals with an organ system level of organization and a closed circulatory system. Phylum Chordata is divided into three subphyla: Urochordata or Tunicata, Cephalochordata, and Vertebrata. Subphyla Urochordata and Cephalochordata are also referred to as protochordates. These animals are found only in marine habitat. Urochordates have a notochord only in the larval tail, while cephalochordates have a persistent notochord, which extends from head to tail region. Acedia and Dolaeolum are examples of urochordates, while Branchiostoma is an example of cephalochordates. Members of subphylum Vertebrata possess a notochord during the embryonic period, which is later replaced by a cartilaginous or a bony vertebral column. Vertebrates have a 2, 3, or 4 chambered heart for circulation of blood, kidneys for excretion and osmoregulation, and paired appendages which could be either fins or limbs. We have studied how animals are classified as hemichordates and chordates on the basis of certain morphological and anatomical features.